or day. If you teach me how to fish, I can eat for life. I just want to thank for all the teachers' hard work and dedication, and also that my help support my final grades. Let's give all of them.
Started to spark some interest into me as I played through piece after piece and listened to recordings of violinists like Heifetz and Oistrakh. It was also through a particular friend of mine who fueled my love for music. As I dove further, I found that others noticed my interest. My friends and family asked me things like, "You're going to major in music, right? You should do this as a career," or, "What else are you going to do other than music?" Well, I didn't play music because it was the only thing that controlled my life. I did it because it was something I enjoyed. It was my creative palette. As I pulled the bow across the strings, the hair covered in fine rosin glided across the silver like butter, creating a ringing and resonant voice. As I painted those musical phrases of Mozart and Beethoven through my violin, my mind became thrilled and enlightened. This satisfaction was what propelled me to play music. My goal wasn't to regurgitate notes from a piece of paper, but rather it was to add color to my world. Rehearsal after rehearsal, the thought of doing music over marine life weighed on my conscience. Should I really be playing this Dvorak symphony, or should I go out and hope an endangered porpoise? I had trouble figuring out what I'd be doing with my future, and even if I'd have a successful life or not. My friends and family could only see my future being about music. But was music something I'd be willing to take on as my life career? Was it music or the ocean? In reality, I don't really need to know what I'll be doing with my future. I'm only 15. I shouldn't let these doubts stop me from doing what I enjoy, and neither should I let others persuade me to do something just because I'm good at it. Rather this, do what I love most.
Administered in more than 140 different countries, including Russia, the Republic of Georgia, not a state, and it's one of those great ways in which we can find camaraderie and compete in a productive and peaceful manner with former Soviet states. So without further ado, here's
as usual, York did very well, more than half of our students getting recognition. I'm going to start with my Latin ones, with the recognition of cum laude Ella Fisher, magna cum laude Abigail Romero, Leonardo del Toro, Sophie Lucan, Isaac Chen, Danica Tang, silver maxima cum laude Jasmine Aga, Jason Mao, Angela Goulart, Avery Danielson, and Cynthia Ortiz-Naranjo. And gold summa cum laude, Rio Ishiguro, Chris Berti, Courtney Hand, Seth Mann, David Lynn, Jordan Mosbach, and Alana Shapiro.
And with distinction from my students in Latin 1, we've got in reverse order Ms. Panes, Mr. Fleischman, Ms. Keech, Ms. Schmidt, Maya Contreras. In the Latin 2 class, we've got Mr. Barry Smith, Ms. Fay, Ms. Storrs, Mr. Lorenz, Mr. Galloway, Tom, right up here. and in Latin 3, with distinction, we've got Miss Smock, Miss Sanford, the other Miss Sanford, Miss Capistrano, Miss Lee, Miss Witt, KBP, Miss Von Berg, Miss Lee, and Miss Wrong. And in the Latin 4 YAS class, everyone who took the exam got an award. So congratulations to Miss Allen, Miss DeVore, Miss Harrison, Mr. Aga, Mr. Burks, and Miss Tame.
Coming in late, so thank you.